What does it look like?
What?
I'll see you tomorrow.
Bless me, Father, for I have sinned.
Continue, my child.
Father, I've been sleeping with my fiancé. What is my penance, Father, that I may be forgiven?
Continue. flesh will always be flesh, my child. My vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. Your penance is death!
Let us pray, O God, by whose mercy rest is given to the souls of the faithful, in your kindness bless this grave. Entrust it to the care of your holy angel, and set free from all the chains of sin the soul of her whose body is buried here, so that with all your saints she may rejoice in you forever. O Lord, we implore you in your fatherly love, have mercy on the soul of your servant Susan, and grant that, freed from the stains of her mortal life, she may receive her inheritance of eternal salvation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Wesley. It's time to go home, son.
Come on, Wes. Let's go.
I can remember when you and Jonathan used to play and have fun like that.
No, not now.
Thanks for everything, Mark.
That's all right. I'll take the car back to the funeral. You take care of yourself.
Wesley, you have no respect for the dead. Every time I mention your brother Jonathan's name, you...
Mom.
Say why.
Wesley has no respect.
I'm going to do with that boy. Lord knows I've tried.
Carl, what am I going to do with that boy of yours? He has no respect. No respect at all. I wish you'd speak to him.
Now, Agatha, Wes is a good boy. He's been through a lot these last few days. You know what it's like, Agatha. You know what it's like to bury someone you love.
call it a night. Leave me alone.
Wes, you've had enough.
Enough of what? She's been gone a year now. This drinking isn't going to bring her back. Why don't you go away for a year?
Yeah, sure.
Let's go. Mother will be worried.
You leave me alone, you...
Okay, Wes.
Okay. You've had enough, boy. Let's go. Get out. I wish it was mine.
You, ma'am?
Yes, please. Thank you.
I knew it'd be him. He's been looking for trouble all night.
You certainly found it. Here, help me get him in my car.
Sure. Come on, boy. Upsidaisy. Come on, boy. Let's go now. Come on. Upsidaisy, boy. Let's move it up now.
Good morning, Wesley Stewart.
Who the hell are you? Where the hell am I? Where the hell is my head?
You'll be all right, Wesley Stewart. I've made sure of that. Who were your friends last night?
What are you talking about? What friends?
It doesn't matter. Here, drink your coffee.
Look, before we go any further, would you mind telling
me... My name is Kay Jensen, and I'm a registered nurse.
A little lower.
So now. I was coming home from work, from a late shift, when I see three men bashing your brains in. I stop, and they take off like bats out of hell. I then get out of the car and see you bleeding like a stuffed pig. With a little help from a bartender, I put you in the car and start to drive home. You then immediately become a police siren. What's that on mine? I figure you're drunk, just been beat up, and if you want to be a police siren, be a police siren. Then those funny friends of yours show up and want to play chase. What'd you do to those three guys? Well, anyway, I finally get you home, clean you up, and put you in bed.
Things like this just don't happen.
Oh.
Hey, by the way.
Yeah? What do you need?
My pants.
Well, they're in here, drying.
You mean I stayed here all night like this?
Uh-huh.
And you put me here?
Uh-huh.
Where did you sleep? Did I try... Did I do any good? Got rid of that stuff.
And I've ordered the things for the garden. We can start on that right after lunch.
Mom, I forgot all about that. I'll get to it tomorrow.
Wesley, I was counting on it today.
No.
We put it off so long.
Oh, no, Mom, but Kay and I made plans to go to the beach. I'll get to it tomorrow.
Wesley, I am tired
tomorrow,
of
tomorrow, Mom. About it.
Remember when we met?
Not really.
Wes? This may sound funny, but here I am going with a guy who I found drunk in the street, and I still don't know anything about his family. Oh, I met your mother, I know. But I don't know anything about your father or younger brother. Your mother...
I'd rather not talk about it.
Well, if you can't talk about it now, Wes, when will you be able
to? It's not that we can't talk, it's just that...
Wes? What's wrong? Wes!
It's all right. It's nothing.
Are you all right?
It's nothing. I'm fine. You want another beer?
We're out, remember? Want me to go get some?
No, that's all right. I get some down at the store down the beach.
Want me to come?
Well, that's all right. I'll be right back.
The damn thing.
Dear Bennett, Wesley in grave trouble. Being held for suspicion of murder.
Wait a minute. Let me see that. suspicion of murder. Please come as quickly as possible, as I believe sickness has returned. Agatha. Cancel all my appointments. I'm leaving town for a couple of weeks.
But Dr. Moss, what about the state board meeting tomorrow?
Cancel it. Tell Dr. Roberts to go in my place.
But you remember what happened the last time.
Claire, tell him anything you want to. I'm going out of town for a couple of weeks. If they don't like it, they can crap it.
Oh, no, no. I told you 1,000 times how it happened. When you keep on with the same questions, you'll just get the same answers because it's the truth.
Truth? Come on, Stuart. You can do better than that. First it was the Collins girl, then the Jensen girl. Who have you picked out next? Or haven't you met her yet?
You're a real funny boy. No, no. Why would I call you and then stay around and wait to be arrested? You have to be nuts to do something like that.
You're right, Stuart. You'd have to be a psychopath. Or like you just said, nuts.
Don't call me that!
Call you what? Nuts? Hit a soft spot, didn't we, Stuart? Is that what you are, nuts? I can't figure you out. Nice boy. Killed two girls. Two beautiful girls.
This reminds me of the Anderson case.
Same thing. Two beautiful girls. Remember the Anderson case, Spinelli?
Yeah. The Anderson case. You remember the Anderson case, don't you, Stuart? Oh, you must have read about that. It was in all the headlines. You killed two girls. Just like you did. He was nuts, too. He had another problem. He didn't like girls at all. He was a fag. Fruit. Is that what you are, Stuart? A fag? A fruit? Is that why you killed him? Are you a fruit? You're nuts, aren't you, Stuart? That's why you killed him.
I told you not to call me that, you... Call it! That's enough! Let him go! Enough. You're free, Stuart. You can go.
This is really happening, isn't it, Lieutenant?
Yes, it's really happening.
Can I tell you something?
Sure. Go ahead.
I didn't kill those girls.
Thanks again, Mark.
For what?
But you're always there when I need you.
Don't mention it.
I'll see you later.
Wes, do you have to go now? How about a beer?
Oh, man, I'm beat. Let's make it some other time, okay?
I'll see you around.
I think I smell a reporter.
You've got a good nose.
Well, now, aren't you afraid I'll chop you up? I mean, you don't want to be seen with a maniac, do you?
Do you know where the coachman is?
The what?
The coachman.
Oh, wait a minute. What are you talking about?
tell you what. What? You meet me at the coachman tomorrow night at 8 o'clock, and I'll let you give me a story.
A story?
Yeah, your story.
Oh, my story.
I want to hear your side of the story.
The coachman, 8 o'clock.
Then it's the date.
Lieutenant? Spinelli. Okay. They're ready. Okay, let's go.
Where are we going? Hey, what the hell's coming off here?
Shut up.
Doc.
Oh, man, am I glad to see you here.
Where's Sedelli's... Sit down, Wes. Why didn't you tell me, Stuart? Your illness is nothing to be ashamed of, Wes.
I'll never live it down.
Now, Lieutenant, just because the boy spent 13 years in an asylum does not make him a murderer.
I know that, Doctor.
Shock of accidentally shooting his younger brother caused a mental breakdown. And we have to consider Wes's father, too. The action that he took didn't help Wes any. Now, he was not criminally insane.
I didn't
say... He was never charged with a crime.
I didn't say he was a murderer. He's being held on suspicion of murder. But his withholding this evidence hasn't helped his case either. Now, about tonight, Stuart, that doesn't help either. You're lucky, though. The guy isn't going to press charges. So... I'm going to release you into the custody of Dr. Moss.
Here, a young lady left this morning. She stayed with the court.
What was that?
Just a crackpot letter.
Anything you want to tell me, Wes? Why didn't you call me?
I don't know.
Oh, what the hell do you mean you don't know? I don't want that kind of crap, boy. I want straight answers. You're talking to somebody who's spent 13 years with you. Now give.
I don't know. I don't know.
The headaches?
Yeah, they're back. The headaches, the pains, the dreams, everything is back.
Okay, we got that straight. Now, is there anything else, Wes? This is important. Is there anything else?
The blackouts. After everything else, it comes the blackouts.
Wes, why don't you come back with me?
Oh, I'm not going back to that damn
Wes,
place.
Wes, that's enough. I didn't mean back to the asylum. I meant back at my house. You need a rest. And I think I can arrange you with the police. Why don't you just think about it tonight? All right?
Well, we're here.
Where are you staying?
Oh, I'll find a place.
You found it. Let's get your bag.
Wes, wait a minute. Your mother hasn't even had a minute's notice. I can just as well...
Now, mother will be delighted.
Oh, that boy. Come on.
Very thankful that you could come, and so quickly.
Oh, what telegram? What are you talking about?
What am I going to do with this?
What telegram?
Wes, calm down.
See, there was some reason for you to show up so conveniently.
Oh, Wes, that's enough. I've come here to help you.
Wesley, Dr. Moss came here to help you.
Been trying to get me back into that damned asylum ever since I got out. Oh, I understand.
No, Wes, that's not true.
It won't work. You understand that? It won't work. I'll go back to jail first.
Go to hell, you will.
The next time you want to help me, try staying out of my life. Do you understand that? Do you both understand that?
I've never seen him like this, Agatha.
Oh, it's getting worse. I've told Carl about it. It's getting worse, much worse. But Carl just has to leave the boy alone.
You've talked to Carl about this?
Oh, yes, but he doesn't seem to get excited or even care about it. He just says to leave Wesley alone. I really don't understand him sometimes.
Well, Agatha, where are you going to put me for tonight?
Forgive me, Bennett. I know you must be tired, and here I am babbling on about Carl. Well, if you follow me, I'll take you to your room. Tell me, how have things been at the clinic?
Oh, same old things. Day in, day out.
Well, you do look a little tired, Bennett, but... Well, under the circumstances, I couldn't think of who else to call on. And, you know, Carl and I have always thought of you as a friend of the family, not just Wesley's doctor.
Agatha.
Yes?
Well, I'm sure things will work themselves out.
Anyway, I'm glad you're here. Well, here we are.
Oh, this is nice.
It's not much, but we call it home.
Oh, this is fine, Agatha. Just fine.
The bathroom is here, Bennett, and if you need me, do call.
Oh, now don't you worry about me.
I'll see you in the morning, then. Good night.
Night. Aggie. Well, you'll see. Things will work themselves out.
I certainly hope so. Good night, Bennett.
Good night.
Thank you.
that you?
Something I had to take care of.
Well, come on in. Say, you look like you could stand a drink.
I could. Scotch?
Scotch. Water or soda?
Just a little ice.
Just a little ice it is. Sit down. Were they rough on you at the station?
Well, I never was very fond of the police.
Boy, never thought they'd let you go.
What do you mean by that?
Hold it. Boy, you're touchy.
You're right. What sort of fun and games do we want to try now?
about some coffee?
We interrupt this program for a special news bulletin. There has been another brutal slaying tonight. A nude body of an attractive young woman was found in the city's Park Lagoon. Police have issued an all-points bulletin for Wesley Stewart. We repeat, Wesley Stewart, the man who has been under suspicion for a series of similar slayings. This man is dangerous and possibly armed. If you have any information...
What the hell is this? Why me? Why?
Yes.
No! No, I didn't do anything!
Wesley,
I didn't know!
Wesley,
I didn't know!
Wesley, listen to me! It's a mistake!
No, I didn't do anything!
You know that!
Mistake! Dr. Moss!
Wes, what are you talking about?
Dr. Moss, he can tell him where I was. He's our house guest. That's what took me so long tonight. I had to take care of him.
No, Wes, you can't.
I've got to get to him. I've got to find him. He can't help him.
Wes, if you go, get you, Wes.
No. Oh, don't let him get me. Please, don't let him get me.
Stay here. Look, I'll go and get him. You stay here. I'll bring you to him.
All right, I'll stay. I'm chill. Let me down. Get him. Bring him here.
No.
Don't tell anybody this.
Wes. I'll be back soon.
One move and I'm gonna kick your ass. You understand that, boy?
Thank you.
Girl wasn't in the apartment, Lieutenant. There was no sign of a struggle either.
Okay, Stuart. Where is she?
You heard him. Where is she? Why, you little bastard.
Oh, wait, stop it. That's enough. All right, Stuart. Now, where is she?
She's going to my place to get Dr. Moss.
Yeah. Okay, Fredericks, let's go.
Wait a minute. Listen to me. Dr. Moss knows where I've been. Angel, she can tell you, too. Please. You've got to go to my place and talk to Dr. Moss.
Sorry, Stuart. The only place you're going is headquarters.
Dr. Moss? Mrs. Stewart?
Spinelli!
You've got to listen to me. Dr. Moss and the girl are at my house. She went there to get him after we heard the radio report.
What do we have to listen to all this crap again for?
Shut up, Spinelli!
Please. Okay, Fredericks. 4417 St. Charles. Thank you. This better be on the level, Stuart.
You should have gone while you had the chance, my child. I'm afraid I can't help you now. You won't let me.
Why me? What did I do?
Why? Because Wesley can't have any friends.
Not after killing my baby, Jonathan. Not after making his father, Carl, commit suicide 13 years ago.
Not for me. No more blood, Agatha. Let me die.
God. No, you can't die. I've kept you alive for 13 years. She must die, Carl. She must die!
Angel! We're here, go ahead, boy.
You understand, Carl?